I tell you a little story. One day I was looking through Lyman and Woolner's book, Striped Bass Fishing, an old book that was came out in the early 50s, and I saw a drawing of a device attached to an eel. And I'd never seen anything like this. It was on the front of the eel. It looked like it was a wobble plate to make the eel go wiggle. So I talked to my friend Al Benson. I said, Al, what is this? Well, he started to tell me that back in the mid-50s, a friend of his showed up at the Cape with these things, which he called whistles. And he proceeded to kill all kind of fish. He caught fish no one else was catching them. And so I said to Al, how was it made? And he described it. And I went and got the copper pipe that he used, drilled a hole for a screw with a nut and a washer, made a hole here, and then flattened this end of it out and drilled a hole for the line to be attached, and used the Dremel tool to kind of take all the burrs off. And the way you attach it, here's your rigged eel with the wobble plate in front. When you cast it, runs, because of the wobble plate, causes the eel to come up. It swims very close to the surface, so it's good for shallow areas. And it causes the eel to swim like a real eel. But you don't have to work the eel. Like a regular rigged eel, you have to work it. This, you just reel it in straight and it wiggles all by itself. I found it just amazing that Al knew the guy and remembered the incident and how this was created. Has anyone used this in the past 50 years? I don't know. I certainly used it and caught a few fish on it. As a follow-up, which was really funny, was after this guy came to the Cape and was catching all these nice fish, I'm told by Al that all the hardware stores on the Cape ran out of copper pipe. Everybody was going and buying copper pipe and putting these things together. I don't know if that would happen this day and age, but back in the day, this is what guys did.